Zero today as the first day of BlizzCon 2017 and as if as one for every BlizzCon previously, Blizzard kicked off the show with its opening ceremony. It's during the ceremony that Blizzard talks about what's coming up in its games, and this year it certainly didn't disappoint. In fact, save for Diablo 3, Blizzard had something big to announce for each game in its catalog. Blizzard CEO Mike Morhaime started the reveals by announcing that StarCraft II will soon be going free to play. Players will have yet to purchase any StarCraft II campaigns will get Wings of Liberty for free. Willy Thassa, who already own Wings of Liberty, will get its follow-up, Heart of the Swarm, for free instead. StarCraft II's Ranked Ladder will be completely free for all players. Will Coop Commanders will free to play up to level 5 for everyone as well. While that means the meat and potatoes of StarCraft II will be free no matter what you own, you'll still need to pay for any campaigns you didn't already own should you want to play through those. Blizzard's eSite will be offering existing single-player content in a bundle for $39.99. Though the campaigns will be available separately for $14.99 each. StarCraft II goes free to play on November 14, so get ready for that. On the Heroes of the Storm front, well-earned Thothinza from Uber and Alexstrasza from World of Warcraft will soon be joining the roster of playable characters. Hanzo, unsurprisingly, will be ranged assassin while Alexstrasza will be support hero, capable of transforming into her dragon aspect for month and eater rises. Blizzard also teased a gameplay update for Heroes of the Storm coming in 2018 that will bring sweeping changes to matchmaking, stealth heroes, mercenaries, and more. As expected, Over will be getting a new hero as well. Her name is Moira, and although I don't know very much about her at the moment, her cinematic reveal trailer certainly suggests that she'll be formidable support or row within the game. Over will also be getting a fourth wall breaking map called Blizzard World, which a hybrid theme park map based on Blizzard's other properties. Jumping over to Hearthstone, game director Ben Brodda took the stage to reveal a new expansion called Kobolds and Catacombs. This expansion will add 135 new cards to the game, along with a new roguelike mode called Dungeon Rush, which tasks the player with fighting their way through a group of difficult encounters using only the cards they're given. It's like an interesting replacement for single-player adventures, which were axed when Blizzard switched to an early-release schedule for Hearthstone earlier this year. Finally, we come to World of Warcraft. Most people were expecting Blizzard to announce a new WoW expansion at BlizzCon, and the company did just that. The new expansion is a Khaled Battle for Azeroth, and it takes us back to the Core Alliance Evs, Horde conflict that has been central to the Warcraft series since every first game. As always, the cinematic trailer Blizzard debuted for Battle for Azeroth looked awesome, and you can check it out below. However, that wasn't the only thing Blizzard had on deck for World of Warcraft. After much demand from fans, Blizzard also revealed that it will soon launch legacy servers for the game under the banner of World of Warcraft Classic. Not much known about the 7 servers just yet, but you can bet that it has longtime fans excited despite the lack of details. Blizzard didn't venture too much deep about any of these new features and expansions that will come later this weekend during the various panels at deep dives during BlizzCon. In other words, even though details are slim right now, it won't be long until we find out more. Which of today's announcement shave you most excited? Head on to the comment section at let us know.